Okay, as you can see, the water is now 82 degrees. So, as part of my personal growth and training, I'm going to try to learn to touch a pitcher that's got hot water in it with the side of my hand to recognize what the temperature is. So, let's put this camera on this way. And 82 degrees going into the pitcher. You can already see the steam coming out. And now this is half. So I don't know if you can see the steam because the lighting is not in the back. But what I'm gonna do is get the thermometer in here. That way I've got a tutorial guide. And let me see if I can put this on this way so I can see. Currently the temperature is like 80 degrees, right? So let's see what it feels like. Ooh, wow, 80 degrees is hot. You don't want to you don't want to be putting your hand on that. That, like, if that's gone past, if, ooh, wow, that's hot, so hot. Ah, it's so hot. If you touch, oh my gosh, why am I touching it again and again? If you keep touching it, which I still am, with the side of your hand, you're gonna really injure yourself. Ah, ooh, but it's so, ah, no, okay, I can't touch that anymore. It's so hot. Okay, I need to cool that down. So right now it's like 80 something. But it's interesting to see that it takes quite some time for the temperature to drop, right? I've been searching around for how long it takes for the temperature to drop. So technically, if I were to like heat my milk up to, why isn't this in focus? Heat my milk up to 70 degrees, it would take. So far it's been 20 seconds. Took 20 seconds for it to drop from 80 to 75. Okay, can I touch 75? Whoa, still really hot. Ooh, still hot. Still really hot. But I can like, it's not as burny. Like it's still like pretty darn hot to touch. I'm gonna put this on a towel so it doesn't sink the heat as quickly. Okay. Oh, it hurts the most over here. Over here it's okay actually. Oh, no, that's bad. Oh, that's so hot. Oh, 70 degrees is hot. Oh, that's what they want to make the coffee at. Because when customers ask for a coffee, they're like, I want my coffee extra hot. So I think maybe like if I do 65 and I heat up the cup really, really warm, like I put it underneath hot water, then I reckon that will compensate for the. Because if you pour the coffee into a cold cup, it's just gonna sink all the heat. Ooh, ooh. Oh, ooh, still hot to the touch, like really hot. But I can sort of keep it there for one, oh, 1 second. 1 second is as high as I can hold it. Ah, man, the stupid things I do to get better at stuff. Oh, my hands all red. Okay. So this is the top of the pitcher, and that's not you can't feel squat there, so no point putting my hand there. I gotta put it here at the bottom. Oh. Okay, let's swap cameras with a hand. Hold it with we all okay, currently you're just gonna trust me. Currently we're on 70 degrees and oh ah whoa. Oh, 70 degrees is really hot. That's what I have to bring the milk to. Okay, so I have to just kind of remember the pain or how hot it is or how long I think, how long I can hold this for. Basically, if I touch it and it hurts, that's about 70 degrees. But at 80, it was like I could hardly touch it. So currently we're on 69 degrees. I don't know. What's the difference between touching the bottom? I think touching the sides better because you can feel all around. Oh my gosh, that is painful. But it's worth it. Personal growth. Okay. So right now, let's see what the difference is if I touch it with my fingertips. Fingertips. Oh, about a second. Okay, finger, this part. What are those called? I don't know. That's really sensitive there. So it's like the whole finger part, like these four fingers, is sensitive. Let's try the palm. Okay, currently 68 degrees. Palm is like not really anything the same. Still, everything is sensitive and hurty at anything past like 65. But I can sort of keep it there a little longer now. At 65, I can hold it one. Ah, so hot. It hurts. Okay, let me show you. Let's see. Currently on about 65. So about 65. 60. Ah, here we go. 65, I can put my hand on it. One, two, just about a good second. If I count to one, I have to let go. One, and then it's too hot to touch. But at 70, it was like you touch it and it burns you. So, what, about 1.5 is my max pain threshold. So for me, with a cold hand, oh man. About one to two. So basically, if you count, well, this is for me anyway, if I count from 1 to 1.5, I know it's roughly about 65 degrees Celsius. If I touch it and it burns me instantly, then I know like it's gone over 70. The hardest part is figuring out what 80 and 90 is, because after 70 everything feels the same. It's like hurty, but I can touch it for a small period of time, I suppose. Whereas 80, and at about 80, I touch it and instantly burns me. So hopefully I won't take it that far, and I'm holding it and I can feel it. One. Yeah, so if I'm making the coffee, I'll just touch this top part. If I'm making the milk, I touch it and I go, feel it. And then eventually it gets to the point where you go, oh, I feel pain. Then you let go and then you test, I think. I test to see, because at this point I'm like, oh, well, what temperature is it? So then I test to see how long I can touch it for. So I let go when I start feeling pain a bit. And then I go back and I go, one. And that's, then you know you're roughly at about 65. And I think that's a pretty good indication. If you're a barista and you're watching this, or you a home coffee maker and you're watching this and you know more tips, please tell me. I am a complete novice and I just really want to get good at this, but it's really hard watching videos on the internet because they're like, oh, then you pour this, and then you pour this, and then you touch this, and then it's all done. Lovely. And then you go and do it, and I'm like pouring like nothing compared to anything I've watched. So those people must have been pouring for ages. But I've poured like 4 cups of coffee. 2, including training, 2 last night. And now, okay, temperature is now at 61 degrees. 2. 2 seconds. I can touch this for 2 seconds. The difference between 5 degrees is huge. 1, 2, and then it hurts. So if I can count to 2 while touching, it's not hot enough. 1, 2, yeah. If I count to 2 and it hurts, that's 60. If I count to 1 and it hurts, that's 65. If I touch it and it burns, that's near 70. So if you ever want to get super hot coffee, I guess you can bring it to 65. And because from there on, I find it harder to gauge what it is with my hands, you can just like heat it a little bit more, I guess. A little bit, like 1 second. Because after that, your milk's gonna scald and then it'll taste gross. Okay, this video was way too long, but that was fun testing. So now it's gone to 59. Yep, 3 seconds. Yeah, so 3 sec. If I'm holding it 3 seconds, 2, 3, nice and cold. Then, yeah. But I suppose if you're wondering, can you like injure yourself? Probably not, because like my hand is still like relatively okay. No burn marks. And it doesn't feel that bad. So you can see at the moment it's on 60. And I can lift it for 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, yeah, definitely don't hold it by here. So, yeah, you can, about 60, you can hold it for about 3 to 4 seconds. Or I can anyway. And I wonder what my right hand's like. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, about the same. And I haven't touched anything with this hand. So it's not like I've been priming my hand for it, right? Like, it's the same whether or not for both ends. Whether or not my hands will get used to this over time, I don't know. Like, 'cause, you know, chef hands, right? If you do it long enough, you'll have like, your nerves will be like, yeah, whatevs, 70 degrees, let's go. But yeah, I say 3 seconds on 60 degrees, 2 seconds on 65, and 1 second on 70. Time to do more training.